Day 10, here in Thailand. The fear and loathing had begun to set in. I decided it was time to head for the airport and return to Bangkok. I'd had enough of this small town life. And here we are, the Chiang Mai International Airport. It looks like quite a few people can't wait to get out of Chiang Mai.
Here's something unique to Asian travel: luggage wrapping service. For a small fee, you too can have your suitcase in 30 layers of plastic.
As far as small town airports go, this one's pretty decent. You've got your token Starbucks, shopping galore, plenty of ATMs, quite the variety of food choices. Let's skip this healthy nonsense and head toward Muay Thai. I don't know about you, but I'm in the mood for a nice giant hamburger.
One thing I've learned about international McDonald's dining is that the cashiers usually speak English and they accept credit cards. These little round plastic discs are actually ketchup holders for your American ketchup. Ah, that looks like my plane. It's not ready to board yet, so I will head over to the gift shop. Ooh, 50% off exotic animal hides.
95,000 baht. That's over 3,000 American dollars. No thank you.
Fortunately, there's plenty more to see here in the gift shop. In fact, there's no need to go shopping anywhere in town. Everything you see in town is right here at the airport. Rather than hauling it all around town with you, just wait until it's time to catch your flight. Okay, my flight is ready to board. So let's head on down the walkway and get on this shiny flying metal serpent in the sky.
Ladies and gentlemen, may we remind you that this is a non-smoking flight. Smoking is forbidden anywhere on the aircraft, including the toilets and in the aisles.
I gotta say, it's quite a relief to be up in the sky, watching the city of Chiang Mai disappear into the horizon. Time to check out the dining choices here on this flight. Not bad. If you don't have time to eat at the airport, save your appetite for the flight. And here we are, in Bangkok. This time I'm flying into the Don Mueang Airport. Time for the long walk to the baggage claim area. Gotta love it when your suitcase is the first one on the conveyor belt. And it looks like there's a variety of rental car and SIM card options when you exit the building. Okay, life lesson number one. Despite the online reviews that say you can catch a train from this airport into downtown Bangkok for just a few dollars, do not do what I did and believe those reviews. There is no need to haul your luggage up these stairs, across this long walkway, and back down again to street level, because there are no trains here. Even after double checking at the ticket counter, apparently at this time of day, there are no trains going that way. Which I find really hard to believe, in this giant metropolis, you cannot pick up an Uber from this train station. So, you're left with no choice other than taking one of these expensive taxi cabs. Negotiating a price with a taxi in Thailand is an art form in itself. They start at about 2,000. You counter with 200. They'll complain to you about how they have a wife and kids to feed. Yada, yada, yada. And after some time, you've hopefully agreed upon a price that works for both of you. However, the rate you agree upon is more when you reach your destination. That's because your negotiations did not take into account the time spent as the taxi cab driver refills his gas tank and the additional fee when he decides to take the expressway. Most of my taxi ride was spent just sitting idling in rush hour traffic. I finally reached my destination, and now it's time to pay the piper.
Five or make.
And here is where I will be spending the night. The Salil Hotel. Not a bad place at all. It's a real hotel. Electronic locks on the doors. Beautiful accommodations. Real air conditioning that works. A selection of complimentary drinking water, tea, and coffee. A selection of snacks and beverages available for purchase. This must be the bathroom. Wow, impressive. Complimentary shampoo and soaps. Very nice. Is that a rainhead shower? Wow. This turned out to be a great hotel choice. And after a short nap, it's time to head out and take in the sights of downtown Bangkok at night. Not exactly the type of sparks I hoped to see on my night out in Bangkok. Oh, there we go. That's the type of spark you need in your life. The streets of Bangkok are very chaotic, very noisy, very dirty. The smell of exhaust permeating your lungs. It's quite intoxicating. A cornucopia of people and sounds. Anyway, you get the idea. And this looks like a good time to wrap up today's vlog. And if you haven't done so yet, subscribe to my channel. It's free. You can get notifications so you never miss out on a future episode. You might just be the one who helps me reach 1,000 subscribers. So stay tuned, and thanks for watching.